What up guys, J3 here, and we're back today with a new video talking about quick beginner tips that I think you guys should prioritize when you start playing this game. First, let's start this off strong. You know, you gotta look forward to getting units. They could be meta, they could look good. You can like their art, their playstyle, how they perform for your team. For me, I look forward to getting Chen, as you know from the last video. She looks good, she plays good. She's a waifu with sword. This is someone I look forward to, and this is what makes me want to play the game even more. It's that makes me want to do my weeklies and all the other good stuff just so I can have her on my team. I pray that I have her on my team. I know it's gonna be tough, it's gonna be all chance. I think if you guys also have someone to look forward to, they could be meta, such as Yuxai, to have you carry in the range, Silver Ash, that could pretty much do it all, or even Age of Jala that does a ridiculous amount of damage. It could be meta, how they look, anything, but I highly recommend that you find a unit anywhere online that you can look forward to, because I really feel like it will help you get into the game even more. For me, even learn even faster, so I can get them in the future and be prepared. Probably wondering, how are we gonna get more random? How are we gonna get more units? I want some more units. Well, we got a couple places that we could check. We got the missions, we got some weeklies, and we're gonna get some random. We got 500 every week. We got some dailies, 100 every day. So for 7 days in a week, that's 700 a week. So about, you already got 1200 a random just from doing the weekly and the daily. Not even counting the pinboard missions that you could be doing. Got some campaign stuff. Don't be skipping out on the Annihilation. Annihilation, I mean, this is 1600 weekly. But if you're just starting out, you're starting about around 1200 or random. You don't even have to complete the Annihilation. Check it out. So if you can get at least 100 kills, you get about 55 are randoms, and so on. If you actually get 400, you get 255, along with, if it's your first time, you get green certificates, battle records, money. This is all this good stuff to upgrade your units, get more units, golden certificates, more battle records. And then once you complete Annihilation 1, make sure you get 400. Try to. You're gonna go to Annihilation 2, and you can increase your weekly reward crap, and that's even more random. So you got 1600 along with 1200 random from the daily and the weekly missions. So you're getting about 2800 random per week. And then if you do it for 2 weeks, man, shoot, you're getting that much closer to your next waifu. Make sure you're always doing the tutorials in this game. And the tutorials in this game really held my hand in teaching me how to understand how most of the units work, where to place them. But it really helps you understand how most of the units work, probably things you might have overlooked, and they could teach you tips you probably wouldn't have caught by yourself. Make sure you read all that, but it taught me how to use a defender to block more than one enemy. If you're playing this game regularly as any other gacha, you got missions, this is all something we're all used to. We're doing combat, operators, making the squads, but something different in this game that can help you out to build your team, etc., is the base. This is something you cannot ignore. Make sure you focus this as much as you focus your units. This is where you're gonna get most of your passive income. You're gonna get gold from the trading post, battle records from here to upgrade your operators, more medals to trade in to the trading post, dual chips, which you need for your 5 stars and 6 stars to upgrade to E2, which is the last promotion, and more random to summon more units. So make sure you try to understand how this place works. Try to upgrade your control center to version 4, level 4, and try to rush to 3-4 in story. We'll get more in depth with the base in another video, because this is a lot to take in, like a power plant, like, well, why do we need this, dormitory, etc., workshop, reception room. These are all equally important that I have to explain in another. Another tip I would suggest to you guys would be, make sure to do the cargo escorts. Yeah, you get a lot of money from in the beginning from the pinboard missions and the regular missions, weeklies, dailies, but you are guaranteed you are gonna run out of money. So try to get as high as possible on this supply mission, cargo supplies, and try to farm as much money as you can, especially when it's up, because you will run out of money. A lot of things in this game use money, the LSDs. And then of course, try to get your tactical drill up to the last level so you can farm the best battle records and try to level up your units as fast as possible. There's a lot of guides talking about how to complete these maps. I know it's difficult at first, but you just need to keep practicing and make sure you really push to try to get the last levels of tactical drill and cargo escort especially. So the store is pretty straightforward. You could buy packs, help you progress even more by these. I suggest looking up some guys, maybe on Reddit or YouTube, that talk about people buying the packs, see what's worth the value, if it's worth the value, or how much you pay. Make sure you're always getting these packs, these enhancement packs right here. And then for the certificates, for the green ones, these refresh monthly. So if you try to plan it out, for me, I like to get the headhunting permits, arundums first, and then everything else. And then if you have extra green certificates after you buy all of these things, you can get to the second tier. From what I've heard, I've never gotten here, but try to get the materials that you need to upgrade your units, operators, and then the 450 headhunting. I think this is too much. I would rather just hold the certificates unless you do pay, you do put some money into the game and you have way too many green certificates, then head to the third tier. This is for the mega whales. And of course, try to save up for the 6-star. Everyone wants to get that 6-star from the gold certificates. It's gonna take a while, but if you keep playing, I'm pretty sure we'll eventually get to it. I had to get Texas because she was a great 5-star unit. She's probably one of the best 5-star units at the moment. I could name a couple off my head, but that's for another video. These you could pretty much farm for. You cannot farm for a 6-star unit, so you have to take that into consideration. And then for the shop vouchers, I highly suggest you keeping your shop vouchers to get the chip catalyst. The chip catalyst is for making your units into E2, which is the last level again. And this is the only way you can, or from what I know, this is the only place where I know you can get the chip catalysts, and I don't know where anywhere else that you could get these. For the furniture store, of course, this is to raise your ambiance. It's this number right here with the green, and then this is what it costs to build. You get these from doing your dailies, doing your weeklies, and make sure you try to do this once in a while. I'm not really that focused on it, but it does help in the long run, getting your team's morale back up as the higher ambiance you go, because you really need your workers to keep working and try to get as many friends as possible. I know that it's hard to try to talk to people, but you really just need to add anyone. You can go to any type of social media, try to go on Reddit, some Discord, and just add in people, because if you start adding people and then you see this circle-y thingy, visit these people, you get some credits. Credits you could use to buy stuff at the store. And at the store is important stuff. You know, some good stuff. Some real good stuff. And it gets technically a free 4-star. Just by getting credits from your friends and visiting the reception room. Get some more materials for your operators, like, can't go wrong. This is just more stuff that you could get to build up your account, to be stronger. Permits, make sure you're doing it every time you do it though. No questions asked, just make it 9 hours. I'll put a link down below to show what tags that you need to pick that can help you get a unit that you'd like, because there's already a lot of people that already did calculations and tested all the tags to get a specific operator that you would like. But of course, that also takes some luck. I'll get into this in another video, but I think the most balanced team to help you progress through the game would be two guards, which are these two. I have Texas for the DP recovery, and then I have Vigna, which is like Plume. Plume is a 3-star. Texas, you could use, other than Texas, you could use Scavenger or Courier. Make sure you have two snipers, two healers, one AoE, one single target, two casters, one AoE, one single target, one hopefully, not a lot can attack air, but Silver Ash can attack air, and one duelist. So a duelist would be like Malanta, so she could probably take someone out, and then two defenders to hold lane later in the game. Usually this is typically an all-around team. There's obviously way more other types of squads, like annihilation squads. Like I would like to have Shaw, which is a special operator. You really have to figure out the map and see what you really need. There are other special operators such as Cliffheart, Rope, which you can pull units into holes and taking care of a lane, so you don't really have to pay much attention to. So you really have to think and know when units that could really kill your team, such as the AoE Mage or Crown Slayer, getting behind your enemy lines, and try to get 3 stars to get that Originite Prime. But we're gonna save this for another video, because team building is pretty much a huge chunk of this game. I feel like a lot of these tips were pretty rushed. I'm gonna make a video for each that I think that needed some more attention, such as the base, the squads, and then more of the gameplay. But for now, these are the tips that I think each new player should be looking at. Just take a glance and then proceed, and then head back, do some more research about it. Don't forget to comment, leave a like, subscribe if you enjoyed, follow me on Twitch if you want to see me live, from my Discord, I'm always replying on it, and yeah, see you guys in the next video.